In this video, I'll show you how to create an ACE manifest with an ACE In-Bond Shipment using BorderConnect. A U.S. In-Bond Shipment allows for the inland movement of goods that have not yet obtained a customs release and are usually destined to an inland bonded location or bonded warehouse in the United States. These shipments can only be transported by a carrier who's either a U.S. bonded carrier or are transporting the shipment on behalf of a U.S. bonded carrier using a single entry bond. To learn how to become a bonded U.S. highway carrier, click the link at the top of the video now. Once you're logged in, hover over the ACE Manifest menu option and select Start New ACE Manifest. Once you enter all your trip information on the Start New ACE Manifest page, scroll to the bottom and hover over Save and Start New ACE Shipment. Since there's an ACE In-Bond Shipment that needs to be created, click Save and Start New ACE Shipment. To learn how to enter trip information on an ACE Manifest, click the link at the top of the video now. Starting from the top of the Start New ACE Shipment page, select your shipment type. It's currently set to a PAP shipment as that's the most common shipment type, but since this is an ACE In-Bond, click the shipment type and change it to an ACE In-Bond. Next, enter your shipment control number, and if you're hauling another carrier shipment, just click the SCAC to change it. It's important to note that the shipment control number will also be the bill of lading number for the In-Bond shipment. Below, enter the shipper and consignee details of the shipment. When you see a magnifying glass icon, that means BorderConnect will automatically look up the information for you. You can look up the shipper or consignee by entering the first few characters of the name of the shipper or consignee, or the address. And if you need to add a new consignee, just click Add Consignee, add the consignee details, and click Save. We're now ready to move on to the commodities on the shipment, so click Save and Add Commodity. Now, enter your description of goods, quantity, and weight. And because we're creating a transportation and exportation bond in this video, enter the total value in US dollars, and the harmonized code, or HS code, of the commodity. For the harmonized code, all that's required is the first six digits. Now that all the commodity info is entered, go to the bottom and hover over Save and enter in-bond details. Here, starting from the top, select your in-bond entry type, which in this video is a Type 62 transportation and exportation bond. Then below, enter the paper in-bond number, which is also referred to as an entry number. This entry number is usually provided in a sequence issued to you from CBP. You can also have this field automatically filled out for you if you entered a sequence of entry numbers into BorderConnect already. To learn how to do this, click the top of the video now. Next, enter the US in-bond destination, where the in-bond shipment is destined to in the United States. Then, the foreign in-bond destination. In BorderConnect, these fields can be quickly assigned by entering the name of the location or the port code. Now, enter the bonded carrier ID of the highway carrier. This can be the carrier's IRS number, US CBP assigned number, or even a social security number. Then below, the estimated US departure date, the date that the US in bond will be leaving the United States. And if the shipment will be subject to FDA, you can change that here. Next, at the bottom, click Save and back to ACE Shipment, where you'll be brought to the ACE Shipment Details page. Now on the top, you can print, fax, or email the CBP Form 7512 with all the in-bond details generated from what we've entered in BorderConnect. This must be provided to the driver before arriving in the US. Now that we've added all the ACE manifest details for the ACE in-bond, click back to eManifest at the top of the page. We're now ready to get our eManifest on file with CBP. So, at the top, click Sync with CBP. Your manifest status will be changed to two yellow bars, Transmitted. And after approximately 1 to 2 minutes, CBP should accept your manifest and the status will change to three blue bars, Complete Manifest on File with CBP. And once the in-bond entry has been filed, an entry number will be provided on your manifest and the status will be moved to four green bars, Complete Manifest and Entry Numbers on File with CBP, where the driver will then be free to cross into the US. And when the driver arrives at the border, the status will then move to five dark green bars, Arrival Reported at Border, and will be followed up by six green bars, Truck Released at Border, with a message stating that CBP has authorized this in-bond for movement in the United States. Congratulations! You've successfully created an ACE manifest with an ACE in-bond shipment using BorderConnect. This type of trip and shipment is usually completed within about a minute or two, and if you ever need help, please reach out to our friendly support team via chat, phone, or email. BorderConnect also provides a user-friendly U.S. in-bond manager solution for U.S. bonded carriers to arrive and export in-bond shipments with CBP. To learn how the U.S. in-bond manager works and how to arrive and close your in-bond shipments with CBP, click the link at the top of the video now.
Hi, I hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. If you'd like to watch more videos like this, check out these videos here or subscribe below. If you're not already signed up to BorderConnect, you can sign up today for a free 45-day trial using special promo code EASY45. Thanks for watching.